So for my AP research topic, I did a quantitative approach on exploring the effect of music on the individual sociological. So have you like ever wondered like when you're sitting like watching TV and there's like music playing and you're like more drawn to it than like when there's no music playing in the background? So that like I try to take the quantitative approach on to see how music really affects one's perception. So like there are numerous like scientific research done over the impact of music, and that kind of like music is like played into like slowing down the progression of Alzheimer's disease. It's like music is like a positive stimulus to your brain, and it's also like used as like a pain like form of pain relief, because like it redirects your brain to focus on music rather than and it also helps you to kind of increase your IQ. So music is an outer stimulus that is also considered a form of cathartic expression. So you can express your emotions through music. Next slide, please. So there are researchers, these are two major researches done over my topic. The one is from the University of Netherlands. So Jolie and Muir had their like test subjects perform a task in which they had to identify happy or sad faces while listening to happy or sad music. So music turned out to have a great influence on what the subjects saw. When there was no smiley faces present, the subject chose like a normal face, thinking that they saw like they recognized a happy smiley face while listening to happy music, and kind of in like same effect for sad music as well. So another research was done in U.S. National Library of Medicine, National Institutes of Health. Through this research, it found that a key function of music among human population is like its ability to create this unity between like a group of people. It synchronized the identities and helped unite like the way they perceive and act. I wanted to see that in like a religious setting, so I looked into the altar call in my church. So altar call is like a segment at the end of the service where pastor makes an invitation for like any individuals to come forward and to like dedicate religion or like try to like get back like on track with God. So it was first practiced in the 18th century, and it's like since then it's modernized with integration of music in the background. So again, it's like one-on-one interaction for prayer and counseling. Altar call is now like widely practiced segments among the denominations of church. So I wanted to see what my sample of my research is representing. So I looked into about how many people in the United States is affiliated with like altar call practicing Christianity. So according to Pew Research Center's 2014 Religious Landscape Study, it found out that about 70.6% of 35,000 Americans name their religion as Christianity, and how they selected 35,000 Americans is through phone calls. That's for voluntary survey. And from 70.6% of 35,000 Americans, about half of those half of those people associated name named themselves as evangelical and mainline Protestants, which are the religions that practice altar call. And another demographic survey was done at Pew Research Center's religious composition of adults in Oklahoma. And about 79% of 25,000 Oklahomans identify themselves as Christianity, and about 79%, 47% of those indicated themselves as evangelical Protestant. So then I formed my research question, which is how effective is the background music in molding the perceptions of the individuals during the altar call? And I want to see whether there is a difference in influencing the individual's perception in different styles of music. And in my hypothesis, I stated that it does make a difference in regards to different types of music. And I thought that slow music would be more influential and powerful to influence the individual's behavior, as like slow music tends to be more emotional than fast music. So for my method, I picked my church, Victory Christian Center, because it's a really exponentially growing church, and I wanted to see how the altar call also like factors into the church's demographics of the church. So I picked January 24th to February 28th to prevent any like fluctuation in like total number of attendees from like holiday. So I collected quantitative data. I counted total number of attendees at each service. There were three different services, 9 a.m., 11 a.m., and 6 p.m. And I counted number of those who came forward during the altar call. And I defined two types of music, fast and slow. And then from those who came forward during the altar call, I randomly selected 10 people and I asked them informal interview with like questions to like strain out like people who came forward just because like a message from the sermon or like from music. And then my method is kept constant through the research. So the definition is best music, like the first definition is best music. It's more percussive and quick tempo music, and it naturally promotes hand clapping or like. And it can be also described as triumphant, and the theme of like the fast music would be like how one like the battle.